About 3 years ago, I moved to a new city. I brought a MIDI controller with me and had it placed next to a window where my work desk was. Now, if there's one thing I learned about having natural sunlight, well, at least where I was living in Malaysia, is that the UV rays can eventually break down bromine, a chemical in plastic that makes it fire retardant, causing the yellowness that you see. In my case, that was the keys of my MIDI controller, the Novation launch key. Luckily, there's an easy way to restore the yellowed plastic using hydrogen peroxide. Okay, let's get into it.
So this is a MIDI controller that has been left sitting next to a window sill, and you can see that its keys have turned yellow. So the reason it has turned yellow is because of bromine inside the plastic, which has reacted with the UV light, causing it to turn yellow. Now, the solution is to use hydrogen peroxide to react with bromine again and to remove that from the keys here to turn it white again. So, if you Google online, you'll find that they have a site called RetroBrite, which shows you how to create a chemical mixture with hydrogen peroxide and using some sort of cream to make it sort of a creamy texture so you can spread it on top of this keyboard here, right? But what you want to do is, what I've done is I've bought a cream itself, hydrogen peroxide cream, and this is bought from a salon shop, and this is actually used for hair bleaching. So the beauty of this is it comes like in a cream-like substance, so we can use this on top of the keys, leave it there with the UV light on it, and turn them white again. So for this, you need a few things. First of all, you need your tools to open up the MIDI controller, of course the hydrogen peroxide cream, a pair of gloves because you don't want that cream on your hands, and also something like a plastic wrap like this, so we can wrap up the cream and leave it there to stay as long as possible after we put down the cream on the keyboard. So let's get to it. I'm going to open this up and do it all for you to see.
It's easy to buy hydrogen peroxide, but it's best to get it in the cream form. So I managed to buy a bottle online around 10 ringgit. That's about $2 to $3 from a beauty supply shop with 40 volume peroxide, one of the strongest cream mixtures made for hair bleaching. And oh, by the way, 40 volume hydrogen means a 12% hydrogen peroxide mixture. Now the first thing to do is to open up the MIDI controller. So I started by flipping the keyboard and remove its screws. Make sure to keep the screws in the container so you don't lose any of it. You don't have to remove the keyboard screws, so I left them in. I then opened up the MIDI controller after jiggling with it, figuring out the plastic bits that held them together. Then, carefully remove the ribbon cable connectors from the keyboard to the logic board. Ribbon cables are super fragile, so make sure to be extremely careful. Now, you can see the keys are held by some screws, so we have to remove them. At this point, I thought of just applying the cream over the board, but it'll be really messy, so just remove the keys, I guess. The black keys are fine, they don't need bleaching, so I just place them aside. Now that we have the keys removed, just place them flat on the table and start applying the hydrogen peroxide cream. We want to generously apply the cream as we want to cover every single part. Once done, I cover the keys with a plastic sheet, mainly to ensure the cream does not dry out when I leave them under the sun. So I left it under the sun for a good whole day, getting about 6 to 8 hours of sunlight. And because I did this indoors, I adjusted the keys throughout the day, making sure to get UV light hitting every spot.
So we have left this here for over 24 hours, and I want to show you the results. Hopefully it's white. Let's get to it. So I'm going to open this up, and you can see that the keys are somewhat whiter right now. They're not 100% fully white, but it's much, much better compared to the first time we saw it, right? So what I'm going to do right now is just going to take this and put it inside the wash it all off, right? Just gonna put it all here. And the next step is really to go and assemble the keyboard MIDI controller again. But you can see it's immediately white, right? There we go. So what I've just used is again the hydrogen peroxide cream with 40 volume. Just use anything from 10% of hydrogen peroxide in the cream, you should be fine. So anyway, I'm going to clean this off, get back to the MIDI controller, put all it together and show you the end results.
And now, time to put everything back together. Simply reverse the disassembly process and I took my time carefully putting them back together. So here's how the end result looks like.
So there you go, the keys are now white. Not 100%, but at least much better than what we started off with. Right, so was it worth it? Was it worth doing this? Well, I think it was worth doing it. The only hard part of doing it was dismantling and assembling the keys back into the MIDI controller again. So try it for yourself, let me know how it fares for you, and love to hear from your thoughts and your experience in the comment section down below. See you then.
I would say I'm pretty glad with the outcome, and the whole process was actually quite a fun activity, taking some time off usual work.